Hey, I'm Cameron McKenzie at CameronMCNZ on Twitter, and I want to talk to you about extracting data from PDF files. Now, specifically, I want to talk to you about extracting individual fields in your PDF files. I got another tutorial that does screen scraping and more generic stuff, another one that does scraping of tabular data. In this case, I want to talk about grabbing specific fields from a single PDF file. I want to show you how to do that in UiPath. As always, we're going to kick this off by creating a new process project. I'm going to call this extract my PDF data. Allow the project to be created, and once it's created, I'm going to open the main window for workflow. Now, I've got a couple of PDF files here. It's in this folder named attachments, and that first one is the one that I'm going to start extracting data on. I'm only going to do this for one PDF right now. If you stick around for further tutorials, I'll go through a bunch of PDFs and process all the PDFs in a directory at once. But right now, I'm just going to concentrate on extracting data from one PDF file. And specifically, I want to get the date, I want to get the invoice number, and I want to get the total for the invoice. That's the three pieces of data that I want off of this particular invoice. Now, this invoice is called order-1001-PDF, and it's in the C attachments folder. And so I need to use that information and have UiPath create a brand new process that opens up that PDF file in a new window. And the way you do that is you go over here, you've got your drop activity here. I want to find the start process activity. There it is, system application start process. Drop that in here. And in quotes, the process that I want to start is that order-1001.pdf. I want to open that PDF file. And that's going to kick everything off. Okay, now that's the start. The next thing I need to do is tell UiPath that it's actually the Adobe Acrobat reader that I want to start working with. And so that means the next step is I've got to attach that whole Adobe PDF process to this sequence. And there's something called the attach window process. You can see right there, attach window, UI automation window. Drag that over here. And that's going to make it possible for me to run the PDF file and open that up and extract some of its data. Now, right now, it just thinks I'm going to open up any old window. It doesn't know which one to open up. So notice it's got indicate window on screen. I need to kind of minimize this a little bit and be able to get the PDF file on the screen at the same time. I click indicate which window we want to work with, and then I click on this PDF file here, and then UiPath now knows, okay, it's that PDF file I want to work with. By the way, it sometimes in this edit selector, it specifies the file name. So notice it specified the file name and what to open up. I like to deselect that and then maybe click validate, make sure that's okay. If you're looping through a bunch of different files and you've specified the name of the file in here, it's not going to work. So it doesn't really matter for us. We're only going to go on one PDF file for this example. But just in the future, you know, you might want to deselect that if all your files don't have the same name. Okay, so this is a good start. Now we've got that file open. Now what's the next thing we want to do? Well, I want to get some text. So you can go up here and search for get text. Where is it? It's under UI automation element control get text. And I'm going to scroll that over there. And what do I want to grab? Well, I want to grab that date. I'm going to scroll over here, indicate element inside window. It's that date field. Okay, so that looks like it's going to grab the date. I want to do the same thing, exactly the same, just differently. And I want to get the invoice number. So now I click on the invoice number for get text. And then finally, make sure you scroll down on the window so that it's visible. I want to get the total. So I'm going to do get text one more time, indicate element inside window. And now I'll highlight the total. And now I've got three different processes, activities in here, which are going to get the different values for the, well, it looks like the date, the invoice, and the total. Now, if you want to hold on to that information, you have to create variables. So I'm going to create a variable called invoice date. I'm going to create a variable called invoice number. And I'm going to create a variable called invoice total. So those three variables are created. And for the date get text under this output value, I'm going to specify the value as invoice date. And right here, where we get the invoice number, the output value, when that runs, when it gets that text, we want it to assign it, we want to assign it to invoice number. And then finally, when we get down to this total, we want to assign that output to invoice total. And so now we have the file being loaded. We have the Adobe Acrobat program being run. We then have some measure of screen scraping or data extraction, to be more exact, for the date, the invoice number, and the total. We've got that as variables in here. And then finally, maybe I can just print that out to you if you just don't believe. Right, so I look for my message box here, throw the message box there, and I can just, well, I can just reference those variables. So invoice date plus space plus invoice number plus a space plus invoice total. And you got to spell things correctly. Invoice total. Does that look good? My little bad arrow, my little arrow went away. So I think that looks good. Yeah, that doesn't look too good, making it 42%. But yeah, I think you get an idea just looking at it again. The sequence, start the process, attach the Adobe window, get the different text fields and make sure that they're assigned their appropriate values, invoice number, invoice total. And then when it's done, well, we're just going to print that information out to the user. Now, by the way, you can do anything here. You could save it to a CSV file. You could save it to Microsoft Word. You could email it to somebody. So what you do is up to you, you know, but this does get the data into your program, into UiPath. Okay, I'm going to save that. I'm actually going to close that window. I'm going to run the program. You notice Adobe comes up. And then it prints out this message. It says, hey, here's the date. Looks like I got the date right. Here's the invoice number. Looks like I got the invoice number right. 1455. Magically, it did it. And I can't even see that down there. Oh, there it is. There's the total. And as you can see, we got everything in there. And so that's how easy it is to just get UiPath to start extracting data from a PDF. And there you go, that's how easy it is to extract data from your PDF file. So if you enjoyed this tutorial, why don't you head over to theserverside.com. I'm the editor-in-chief over there. We've got lots of great articles on that site. If you want to follow my personal antics, I'm at CameronMCNZ on Twitter, and you should subscribe on YouTube.